tutti.
Hi everyone, I'm here today with Paolo Calabresi. Ciao Paolo.
Ciao Davide.
Do you know where we are? At the start of Passo Giau. It's a climb that everyone knows as part of the Giro d'Italia, the symbolic ascent of the Maratona Dles Dolomites race. 9 kilometers and 500 meters. Luckily, that signpost overestimated it. It boasts a 900 meter ascent. The average gradient is just less than 10%. And we're here to analyze in detail how to deal with the climb. Let's go. The first kilometer is probably the steepest. The gradients are constantly around 12 to 13%. And this is why you immediately need to find the right rhythm. Don't look at the others. If necessary, drop back a bit, but you need to concentrate on finding the optimal rate.
From what I can remember, Davide, it's always really hot at the Maratona Dles Dolomites. The valley is narrow, there's not much wind, and the start of this climb is always difficult.
In 2015, the Maratona Dles Dolomites was scorching hot, and so you really have to drink not very much, but often. Make the most of the hairpin bends and those sections where the gradient eases off a bit. Such as here, for example. Hairpin bend, take it wide, and then drink 2 sips. And another tip, the hairpin bend goes to the right, keep on the left, and when you reach the center, cut across, like this, you'll have a couple of meters of respite. When you reach the first tunnel, there's a 67% section. But immediately after the second tunnel, there's 1 kilometer where the gradient is 11 to 12%. It's really demanding. Then there's the 13th bend. It's here that you can catch your breath.
And Davide, seeing that we've just passed the 4th kilometer, perhaps it's time to stock up on some energy.
Yes, right here, between the 13th and 14th bend.
In just a few seconds, Enervit Sport Gel One Hand provides immediate, one-shot energy.
One shot.
Which means you can continue knowing for certain that you've got all the energy you'll need. And as you saw, Davide, also from an ecological point of view,
one doesn't throw anything away.
Nothing.
Let's talk about gear ratios. At the moment I'm using 34-28 and I'm trying to go at 70 revolutions per minute. 70 a minute means going at a speed of 10.7-10.8. Can you manage this? Okay, so this ratio works well. If you go a bit slower, use 34-32. Because 70 RPM means going at 9.6, 9.7, which is the speed most go at.
Absolutely. On this section, it's easy to drop down to below 10 kilometers per hour.
I see too many climb at 50 RPM. 50 RPM is what pros use to do the hard work.
Power resistance.
After 3 kilometers, you're exhausted. And so, you need the right ratios. If Nibali climbs up here with 39-28, we need 34-28 or 34-32. There's no way about it.
Also because the average amateur needs more than an hour for this stage.
Tell me, How quick the pros climbed this section during the Giro d'Italia?
About 33 to 34 minutes. The best did it in 33 minutes and a half.
Dombrovski set the record for what we know in 33 minutes and 27 seconds. Amateurs, those who win the Maratona Dles Dolomites, require 37 to 38 minutes. 2 years ago, I did it in 48. But when I did the entire marathon in 6 hours, did this climb in 59 minutes, which means that 34, 32 could have been useful for me too.
Not many complete the entire marathon in less than 6 hours, though.
So calculate things carefully. You see, this is the right cadence, 70, 72. Seventh kilometre. We're at an altitude of 2,000 metres. We've said it before and we'll say it again. You must drink energy regularly. Also because as you gain height, it's easy to become dehydrated. Because fluid consumption increases.
I'll do exactly as I'm told.
Let's talk about heart rate. So, if you only have to do this climb, you can reach your limit. If your maximum heart rate is 180 beats per minute, you can climb at 165 to 167 BPM. But if you're competing in the entire Maratona Dles Dolomites, then this isn't possible. You need to try and cycle at a fairly elevated rate. Taking the maximum heart rate of 180 as an example, the cyclist should manage to stay below 160 BPM. I do the following. Maratona Dles Dolomites, I do the first climb, almost at my threshold, because this allows me to break away in a little group and create a little lead of a couple of minutes. But at the second climb, from Bordeaux, I go more steady. My maximum rate is 180. So I aim to go at 155, 158 beats per minute. In a gran fondo like this one, it's important that your heart rate doesn't go too high. Also because
you'll be punished.
You finish your energy reserves, you simply can't make any progress. So you really need to check your frequency. Today's a terrible day, there's even some fog.
We'll head into the clouds.
So, summing things up. On the basis of your max heart rate, your threshold is around 92%. The average is between 80 and 90. Keep within 80 to 85 of your maximum heart rate.
We've almost done it, Davide.
Two.
Come on.
10 to 12 minutes. We can do it.
Not sure about you, but I need some sugar, some carbohydrates.
Go on. Passo Giau, 2,236 metres.
It's over, Davide.
In the rain. And so?
It's always beautiful. Well, for those doing the Maratona delle Dolomites, it's not over yet. They've still got to deal with Passo Felzarigo, Valparola, and then the road to Corvara. For those doing the Maratona delle Dolomites, there's a fantastic refreshment point here, and I recommend you stop and eat.
Precisely. Also, because you can eat something more solid if you want to.
Absolutely.
Sometimes you really need it.
Actually, I'm going to.
Yeah, You can eat here, and if you're in rush, if time is running out, you can eat over there, after the steep descent on the flatter section before Falzarago.
Heading towards Pacol, therefore, before the climb.
I think we've said just about everything. I hope our tips will help you deal with a climb like this one, up Passo Giau.
Thanks, Davide.
Thank you.
Grazie, Davide.
A te.